find the antiderivative of this, what you're going to do, you're going to set tangent squared 3x, right? In other words, we're going to split it, times secant of 3x times one more tangent that we took out, right? Tangent squared plus another tangent gives you tangent tripled, right? So tangent of 3x dx. And why did I do it? Notice that if you use the U substitution now, U is equal to, no, actually, that's too early. That's too early. We need to actually, we need to write this as secant squared, right? Secant squared of 3x minus 1, right? That's the famous identity that we're using. Instead of tangent squared, we're going to use the secant squared of the 3x minus 1, right? Multiplied by the secant 3x times tangent of 3x dx. Right, so then we're going to distribute. We're going to have secant squared 3x times secant 3x tangent 3x dx minus secant 3x times tangent of 3x dx. So now, using the U substitution, notice that if you use U is equal to secant of 3x, the du is going to be 3 secant 3x tangent of 3x, right? So you already see this part here as accounting for this part. So the only thing that you're missing is the 3, right? Since there was no 3, you're going to have to multiply this integral by 1/3, right? So 1/3 u squared, right? Because this part is u squaring it, so u squared, and u squared du. Now, what kind of substitution will you use for this one? For this one, notice that this is easy, right? Because the antiderivative of the secant tangent is simply secant, right? So the antiderivative of this will be secant of 3x, right? So that should be let's set this as v. Actually, we have to set it as v. V is equal to 3x. dv is equal to 3dx. Right? So I'm going to show you what's going to happen. So we're going to have this. So dv is going to be dv over 3. So 1/3 is required. Secant v tangent v dv. And now we can use the substitution. Now we realize that the antiderivative of this will be secant v, right? So we first needed to use the substitution 3x for the v, right? That was too early to think of the antiderivative that we get as a result of having this integrand, right? So now the first integral is going to give us 1/3 times 1/3. Let's write this better. 1/3 times 1/3. U to the third. What is u? U is secant to the 3x, right? Secant tripled, right? Secant tripled, because the u to the third will be the antiderivative. Secant, let me write this better, secant triple 3x minus 1/3. Now the antiderivative is the secant v, right? So secant v, what is v? V is 3x, right? In terms of x, second, right, plus a constant. So this turns out to be 1/9 secant triple 3x minus 1/3 secant 3x plus a constant. Right, so this should be the correct antiderivative. If you got this result, then you did the correct work. Hope this was a lot of fun. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.